I didn't know. Did you know the Yokozuna could move so fast? You see, the Undertaker is not a forgetful guy. He remembers Yokozuna partially responsible for crushing his face, and he's not going to be happy until there's a closure to that incident. Now, do you think Yokozuna will be one of the 30 entrants into the Royal Rumble? I mean, you would not believe people are coming out of the woodwork to get into the Royal Rumble. And you don't want to miss it. It takes place January 21st, live on pay-per-view, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, emanating from Fresno, California. Now, we already know that Big Daddy Cool Diesel is in the Royal Rumble. Owen Hart, the King of Hearts, is also in the Royal Rumble. And just to give you an example of the guys trying to get in, Nature Boy Buddy Landell is in the Royal Rumble. You would not believe the names that I've heard thrown around. Names of the present, some big names from past WWF pay-per-views. All right, let's talk about the WWF title match at the Royal Rumble, January 21st. The legendary Bret the Hitman Hart takes on the phenom here, The Undertaker. And the only thing I'm wondering, Bret has been through two knockdown dragouts recently with the Bulldog and Diesel respectively. And it makes you wonder, how much more does he have left in his tank? Plus, The Undertaker's a guy who's impervious to pain. I mean, how can you tell if your offensive onslaught is working or not? I mean, he's got that poker face. Right now, let's talk to Bret the Hitman Hart and the challenger, The Undertaker.
Three times I've been the World Wrestling Federation champion. And you know, when you're the champion, you get into the habit of sizing up all the different opponents in the dressing room. You always look at him and go, I could take him, I could take him. And then all of a sudden you look at The Undertaker, this flawless reputation he's had over and over all these years. And you always have to ask yourself, can I take him? Well, Undertaker, you got your big shot against the World Wrestling Federation champion. And you know what, Undertaker? Bring the creatures of the night, because you're going down.
Bret Hart, as you sit up there in Calgary, you must be concerned with what the future has in store for you. You must be wondering why would the Grim Reaper come in search of me? It's not because Gorilla Monsoon made me the number one contender. This is gratitude. Gratitude for the creatures of the night. They asked me for the belt, and I will deliver it to them.
Happens after it happens. Take a look at this.
Go back to Survivor Series when I lost the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt to Bob Backlund.
Bob Backlund is celebrating!
Never designed or supposed to be at the ring to be an official in any way in that match.
Owen is pleading for his mom and dad to do something.
I've always had a problem with the fact that I lost that title in the first place.
Oh, no! She threw the towel out! She threw the towel out!
I don't think I really lost the title in a fair, in a true sense.
This is the true Owen Hart!
To me, I should have always been the champion from that point on.
That mindset is what motivated the Hitman through 1995, a year Bret takes on any and all competitors in a quest for what he feels is rightfully his. The year culminates in a showdown for the title against Diesel at Survivor Series. And just when it looks like Bret's quest would go unfulfilled, the Hitman regains the coveted gold.
We have a new champion!
What a grueling matchup, Bret Hart against Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
You know, McMahon, I doubt Diesel will ever have that kind of compassion for another superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation. That's a new attitude Diesel's got. I like it. That's the attitude that got him where he's at right now.
We'll have more on Big Daddy Cool later on. He wants, by the way, a rematch with Bret Hart. Davey Boy Smith wants a rematch with Bret Hart. What an unbelievable battle that was. It just keeps getting tougher and tougher for the Hitman. But the toughest of them all, perhaps, is his upcoming title defense, Bret Hart against The Undertaker.
Could be the shortest reign Bret Hart's ever had the belt for.
No question about it, as we take you now to the Slam Jam.
Hey, 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 welcome to WWF Slab Jam, all my friends in Canada. Hope you had a very Merry Christmas. Know you had a safe and happy New Year, right? Right, okay. You know what else I know?
Conquest. Betrayal. Razor's one-time loyal friend and protege, the 1-2-3 Kid, tired of walking in the bad guy's shadow.